This is Duke University.
Julie Tetel Andresen cares passionately about the world's disappearing languages. So when she and co-author Philip Carter wrote their new book, Languages in the World, they decided to help. They're donating all profits to the Endangered Language Fund, which works to preserve the world's vanishing languages.
Our passion is to see endangered languages get off the endangered language list. If you go to the Endangered Language Fund website, they'll tell you that currently 7,000 languages are spoken in the world. Probably half of them will be lost in the next century. But actually, some linguists are saying, no, it's even going to be more severe than that. It could be 150 languages left in 100 years. Language loss has been going on since Columbus, but it's been in the last 20 years that it's been lightning fast with the spread of globalization. Globalization accelerates the death of local languages in a number of ways. One way is it draws workers from a lesser spoken language out of their native locale into Saudi Arabia or wherever, where their local language is no longer relevant. Another way is huge influxes of tourists. And so suddenly everybody wants to be able to sell their wares to the tourists. People think they need to give up their native language in order to speak another language. And it's a false choice.
Produced by Duke University. Online at duke.edu.